Now we will see the aspects on surface chemistry. Surface chemistry deals with the processes taking place at the surface of any material. So chemistry means combination of matter. So combination of matter takes place at the surface of some material. So these aspects are covered in surface chemistry. In particular, surface chemistry deals with the reactions taking place at the surface of any material. So the reactions taking place at the surface of material are governed by a phenomenon called adsorption. So that we have to have the basic understanding of this adsorption. So adsorption is the phenomenon of higher concentration at the surface than in the bulk of a material. Let us compare. So let us have sand particles and let us have calcium chloride particles. So calcium chloride particles and sand particles, if they are put in a system of water, so water is there, so water composition is H2O, into which two different chemical particles, one is common sand whose composition is silicon dioxide, common sand particles, silicon dioxide, whereas another set of particle system is calcium chloride. Here if you put this sand and calcium chloride particles in two different beakers containing water, and afterwards if you take out this particle, we can observe water particles in both the cases. But in the case of sand, water particles are found only at the surface of the sand particles, whereas these water particles are found in the bulk of the calcium chloride particles. What is in the surface and bulk? The difference is that any particle is assumed to be sphere. Particles are assumed to be spherical in nature. So surface of the sphere means we have to consider the surface area of a sphere. So surface area of a sphere is 4 pi r square, whereas bulk of the sphere means volume of the sphere. Volume of the sphere is 4 by 3 pi r cube, 4 by 3 pi r cube, where r is the radius of the sphere. So for the same particle of particular radius r, only 4 pi r square region is covered by water particles, whereas that is for this silicon dioxide particle, only the outer portion is covered by water particles. Such system is called wet sand because it contains water particles, wet sand. On the other hand, the calcium chloride particles, they will contain water into the whole volume. So 4 by 3 pi r cube is fully occupied by calcium chloride particles, whereas only 4 pi r squared is occupied by sand, the water particles in sand. So sand and calcium chloride particles take water. One set of particles take water only at the surface. Other set of particles take water into the bulk. Bulk means volume. So volume is occupied by water molecules, or only surface is occupied by water molecules. If the surface is occupied by any system, that phenomenon is called adsorption. Then, so once again to condense, adsorption is the phenomenon of higher concentration at the surface. Then, what is the phenomenon called higher concentration at the bulk? That is called absorption. A-B-S-O-R-P-T-I-O-N. Absorption is the phenomenon of higher concentration into the bulk. For example, if we keep paper, porous paper, into which we have put the ink dot, so the ink particles occupy the volume of the paper at the particular place. So whereas if you write with some other scratch material, it will occupy only at the impression, means only at the surface. So impressions are caused only at the surface. Total writing causes results in the bulk. So in general, phenomenon of higher concentration at the surface is called adsorption. Phenomenon of higher concentration into the bulk is called absorption. So here we are dealing with only with the surface phenomena. That is, adsorption is only considered. Before that, if a particular system involves both, or they are, we are telling higher concentration. So if you are not able to distinguish which is higher, phenomenon of concentration both into the surface as well as into the bulk, 50-50 means question may arise. That case it is generally called sorption. So sorption is the uniform concentration of everywhere, also in the surface, also in the bulk. That is to be noted. Now we are confined to our discussion only to adsorption. So adsorption is the phenomenon of higher concentration at the surface. So surface chemistry. So adsorption is of types: positive adsorption and negative adsorption. Another classification: physical adsorption and chemical adsorption. So adsorption, the classification of adsorption: positive adsorption and negative adsorption, physical adsorption and chemical adsorption. In order to understand, let us revise the same silica particles covered with water, covered with water, water particles. So silica particles are said to be adsorbent. Water particles are called adsorbate. So adsorbate is the material which is held on the surface of some other material. Adsorbate is the substance which is held on the surface of some other material. So adsorbate definition involves passivize, is held on the surface of some other material, whereas adsorbent definition takes the as activize, which holds other materials on its surface. So any material which holds other materials on its surface, that is called adsorb. Here silica adsorbs water, or in other words, water is adsorbed by silica. Water is adsorbed by silica. So here silica is called adsorbent, water is called adsorbate. So adsorbent is the material which holds other materials on its surface. Adsorbate is the material which is held onto the surface of other material, adsorbent material. So depending, holding means there should be some type of forces. What is the type of forces? Depending upon the forces between adsorbent and adsorbate, they are classified into physical and chemical adsorption. If the forces, so here we have to compare the forces between adsorbate and adsorbent. So you know, we know that there are three standard states of matter: solid, liquid and gas. So adsorbate can be a solid or liquid or gas. Adsorbent can also be a solid or liquid or gas. So any thing can be so, but adsorbents are better, solids and liquids. It is also possible, higher choice is for, whereas adsorbates are liquids and gases. So adsorbate phases can be generally liquids and gases, adsorbent phases can be solids and liquid. So if there is one liquid, another liquid, one gas, another gas, like this. So what is the type of forces? If this is van der Waals forces, VANDEWALS, van der Waals means these are physical forces. Van der Waals forces means it is called physical adsorption or merely physisorption. So an adsorption phenomenon is called physisorption if the forces existing between the adsorbate and adsorbent molecules are of van der Waals or physical nature. On the other hand, if the forces are covalent in nature, this is called chemical adsorption. So chemisorption or chemical adsorption means the nature of forces between the adsorbent and adsorbate is covalent. Let us illustrate with the example. You consider the same case, that is silica particle. Silica is solid, sand is solid, and this another solid is nickel. It is metal. Nickel is metal. Here let us consider the adsorption of water on silica. Water is one molecule. If this is in the liquid state, water. Water contains enormous number of molecules. Water is in the liquid state or liquid phase. Silica is in the solid phase. Silica is adsorbent, whereas water is called adsorbate. Here nickel metal is solid, that is also adsorbent, whereas nickel, to this nickel if we attach hydrogen, hydrogen is gas, that is adsorbate. Here also there is one adsorbate and one adsorbent. Here also one adsorbate and adsorbent. So the forces between water and silica is van der Waals or physical in nature, whereas forces between nickel and hydrogen is chemical. Nickel forms a covalent bond between hydrogen. So the forces, covalent bond means chemical, they are stronger. Van der Waals forces are weaker, covalent forces are stronger. Stronger force means chemisorption, we will see. So the basic difference between physisorption and chemisorption, here hydrogen is said to be chemisorbed onto nickel, whereas water is said to be physisorbed onto the surface of sand or silica. So physical adsorption or physisorption, chemical adsorption or chemisorption, that is one different one type. Before going to the difference, let us have the different concept of what is meant by positive adsorption and negative adsorption. Let us consider adsorption of any material from solution. Adsorption of material from solution. Solution means automatically it consists of two components. One is called solute, another one is solvent. So solute can be solid, liquid, gas. Solvent can also be solid, liquid, gas. Adsorbate can also be solid, liquid, gas. Adsorbent can also be solid, liquid, gas. So here in this case, what happens if the solute is adsorbed? What happens if the solvent is adsorbed? So there are general expectation is only adsorption of solute from solutions. This is the standard. Any solute, adsorption of solute from solution takes place. Let us consider the case of a salt solution and put it in two types, acetic acid or acetic acid solution. Acetic acid formula is CH3COOH. Acetic acid is a liquid, it is diluted, so you are having some concentration of acetic acid solution which is in the liquid state, and you put some other salt solution. We have two types of solutions. In one, in adsorption, the acetic acid solution, let us put charcoal. Charcoal is put. In the salt solution, let us put sand, silica particles. So here charcoal is called adsorbent because it is the solid medium. Acetic acid is called adsorbate, it is liquid. This irrespective of the amount which is present, just because it is taken in large proportion, it cannot be adsorbent or adsorbate. That we cannot generalize. Which is getting held over the surface of which material, that decides the nature of adsorption. Here in the first combination, charcoal is the adsorbent, this one acetic acid is adsorbate. So if you put charcoal in acetic acid for a period of time and you filter the solution, once again you measure the concentration of acetic acid. So the concentration of acetic acid is measured before and after adsorption. Here there will be decrease in concentration because some amount of acetic acid has been adsorbed onto the charcoal. So if you put the charcoal particles into the acetic acid solution for a particular period of time and filter, the filtrate contains acetic acid, but its concentration is getting reduced because some amount of acetic acid has been adsorbed onto the surface of charcoal. On the other hand, if you put salt sand into a salt solution and measure this one, The concentration, our expectation, concentration will increase during adsorption. Because here sand will adsorb only water particles. Water particles are solvent. Here acetic acid is solute. So if the solute particles are adsorbed, that is the general case, that is called positive adsorption. So that results in decrease in concentration. If the, here C1 and C2 are the concentrations before and after adsorption. For convenience, let us write in this form CB and CA. CB is the concentration before adsorption. CA is the concentration after adsorption. So after adsorption, concentration decreases because some amount has been adsorbed onto the solid. Here, so solute has been adsorbed in the first case. Whereas in the second case, solvent has been adsorbed. Solvent is water is adsorbed. So there is a decreased water content, more same amount of solute, water content has been decreased. So the concentration increases. In general, if the concentration increases after adsorption, this is called negative adsorption. It is negative because against our expectation. Generally during adsorption, concentration decreases. So if the concentration decreases during adsorption, that is called positive adsorption, negative adsorption. So you have to be thorough with these terms. What is meant by adsorbent, adsorbate, positive adsorption, negative adsorption, sorption, now physisorption and chemisorption. Now let us see the differences between physisorption and chemisorption, or chemical adsorption and physical adsorption. So first major difference is physisorption involves van der Waals forces. Van der Waals forces. Whereas chemisorption involves covalent forces. Covalent forces. So van der Waals forces are weaker than covalent forces. So sir, chemisorption is strong in nature and physisorption is weak in nature. So, next one, what is the effect of temperature and pressure? Before considering this, let us consider once again the what are the factors influencing adsorption. What are the factors influencing adsorption? So adsorption is generally reported by means of a parameter called x by m. Here x is the amount of adsorbates, whereas m is the amount of adsorbent. So the ratio of the amount of adsorbate to the amount of adsorbent is called extent of adsorption. Extent of adsorption. So extent of adsorption, how does it vary with the first one, nature of the materials. Second one, so these are the factors. So important factors are nature. Nature means nature of adsorbent, nature of adsorbate. Temperature, pressure, these are the important factors, temperature and pressure. So nature means, in the case of adsorbate, if the gases are easily liquefiable, if the gases are easily liquefiable, they are readily adsorbed, more readily adsorbed. If the gases are not easily liquefiable, they are called permanent gases. Let us see examples for these cases. They are weakly adsorbed. Permanent gases are weakly adsorbed, whereas easily liquefiable gases are readily adsorbed. For this case, let us consider HCl, NH3, hydrogen, oxygen, etc. So hydrogen, oxygen are called permanent gases. Permanent gases means they spend most of the time only in order to liquefy, we got to supply pressure, we got to cool the temperature. Normal state of existence is only gas. Permanently they are existing as gases. So they are called permanent gases. Whereas this one, what is HCl? We will be tempted to tell hydrochloric acid. But it is actually hydrogen chloride gas. If it is represented as HClG, hydrogen chloride gas. If it is represented as HClAq, aqueous, it is the hydrogen chloride is dissolved in water to get hydrochloric acid. So here it has affinity towards water to give rise to acid. Here ammonia also affinity towards water to form ammonium hydroxide, which is a base. Ammonium hydroxide, which is a base. NH4OH. So these are easily liquefiable. But hydrogen and oxygen are not easily liquefiable. Hydrogen is a easily liquefiable gas means more readily adsorbed. More readily adsorbed. Whereas permanent gases weakly adsorb. That is the influence of nature of adsorbate only. What is mean by nature of adsorbent? Adsorbent, if it possesses more surface area that will hold more materials. So actually it is a surface phenomenon. If the adsorbent contains more surface area is more, means holding capacity is also high. Holding capacity is also high. In common example, we can see if you put water and keep out of the palm, if you immerse your palm into water and keep it out, and then if you immerse your palm into a solid powder and keep it out, water particles may or may not be sticking to the surface fully, but powder particles, whatever your lines inside the hand, they will be occupied with the powder particles. So if there is a surface, so actually this type of arrangement is known for its high surface area. If it is highly polished means low surface area. Finely divided means high surface area. So finely divided means, what is mean by finely divided? Let us compare the increase in surface area. You have a cube of 1 centimeter size. If you have a cube of 1 centimeter length, 1 centimeter breadth, 1 centimeter height. It is split into cubes each of 1 millimeter. It is split into smaller cubes each of 1 millimeter side. So how many such cube? So we know that 10 millimeter equal to 1 centimeter. So we will be tempted to tell that here 10 such cubes will be formed. Not like that, because 10 divisions along x axis or length axis, 10 divisions along y axis or breadth axis, 10 division along z axis or height axis. So 10 into 10 into 10, 1000 such small cubes can be formed. 1000 cubes. So one cube, even though we make divisions in 10 along each division, 10 divisions along the length, 10 divisions along the breadth, 10 divisions along the height. So 10 into 10 into 1000 cubes can be formed if total surface area of bigger cube is 6a square, smaller cube is small a square, 6 small, but ratio is 1000. So this is the 6a square is the total surface of area of the bigger cube, 6 small a square is the total surface of the smaller cube, but 1000 cubes have been formed in this manner. So against our expectation a by a whole square, there is also a ratio of 1000. There is also a ratio of 1000. If it is finely divided, there is enormous increase in surface area. So finely divided material, higher surface area for the adsorbent means more is the amount of adsorbed. So extent of adsorption increases with the surface area of the adsorbent. Here liquefying capacity for the gases. This about the nature. Next is effect of temperature. You have, what is the effect of, if you increase the temperature, what is the extent of adsorption? Extent of adsorption is x by m, we should not forget. So extent of adsorption, generally it is inversely related to temperature. Higher the temperature, more amount will not be adsorbed, because adsorbed amount will be removed during heating. So the common example is wet sand. Wet sand, if you heat, it becomes dry sand. So sand composition is same, but what is the difference in the amounts of water content? Wet sand loses water particles on heating. So on heating means you are supplying temperature. If you supply heat, the temperature is increased. Temperature is increased means the water content is reduced, so it becomes dry. So this absorption, extent of absorption is inversely related to temperature. So x axis is x by m, y axis is temperature. If you increase the temperature, it will be reduced. That is to be noted. That is the effect of temperature of the adsorbate or system if you increase or decrease water. Next is the effect of pressure. So extent of pressure, if you increase the pressure of the gas, more amount of the gas is available per unit surface area. If more available amount of gas is available per unit surface area, amount of adsorbed is more, amount of material adsorbed is more. So x by m is directly proportional to pressure, inversely proportional to temperature, directly proportional to concentration if it is a solution. So adsorption can be either from solution or adsorption of a gas. So adsorption of a gas increases with the pressure of the gas. Adsorption of a gas increases as temperature is decreased. Adsorption of a solute increases as concentration increases. So these are the effects. These we have seen the qualitative effect. If they are put in the graphical form, the graphical plots are called. So the isotherm and isobar, isocore. So there are three types of adsorption graphs. Adsorption plots are called adsorption isotherm, adsorption isobar, adsorption isocore. Iso means same. So temperature, therm means temperature. Same temperature plots are called adsorption isotherms. Same pressure plots, bar is the unit of pressure. Constant pressure plots are called isobars. Constant volume plots, they are called isocores. So here volume is constant, here pressure is constant, here temperature is constant. So general x by m versus p, it will follow roughly in this fashion, exponential. This is T1, T2, T3. This is called isotherm. Isotherm is a graph. All these are graphs. So at a particular temperature T1 or at a particular temperature T2, at a particular temperature T3. This is called adsorption isotherm. Isobar means effect of temperature. Iso, we know that extent decreases. But as you increase the pressure, more amount will be there. So these are called iso. P1, P2, P3 are the pressure values. T1, T2, T3 are the temperature values. Y-axis is the extent. Y-axis is always extent of adsorption. Extent means x is the amount of adsorbate material and m is the amount of adsorbent material. T is the temperature. And just now we have seen that it is directly related to pressure and inversely related to temperature. This can be combined, put in this manner. So extent of adsorption increases with the pressure and decreases with the temperature. So in order to have fixed value of x by m, what is the temperature pressure relation? That is called isocore. Isocore, constant volume or temperature versus pressure. So temperature pressure values for different cases of x by m. Different cases of x by m. Suffix 1, suffix 2, suffix 3. So these are called isocores. So we have seen three types of graphical plots: adsorption isotherms, adsorption isobars, adsorption isocores. Isotherms are the constant temperature plots, isobars are the constant pressure plots, and isocores are the constant volume plots. Now we can see the differences and comparison between the physical and chemical types of adsorption, namely physisorption and chemisorption, in detail.